Right there, fishing buddies, I've just bumped into two people and they're doing a brilliant course, and I'll tell you what they're doing.
Hi, I'm Hello. Sinead.
I'm Alan.
And we're running from Meriden to Bury for the Northwest Air Ambulance, and we're handcuffed together.
It's yeah, brilliant.
Yeah. Give them a thumbs up, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's gorgeous, that's mate. Well done, Paul. Brilliant. Yeah. That's nice. Yeah.
That's been my day.
Yeah, that's it, yeah. That's nice. Have you took the hook out?
Yeah.
That's lovely,
best
though.
Best photo, mate.
Took
a photo.
Took a photo, yeah.
Right there, fishing buddies. You're joining me and Kev. We're off to a canal. I'll be letting you know where we're going. This bright spark's turned up this morning and you will be revealing. It's right, Kevin's playing radio over the top. Yeah, we will reveal what Kev's been doing. He's upgraded again. Absolutely super what the man's doing. So take care all, and let's see if we can catch some fish. Take care. So first port of call this morning is coming down to Dolphin Tackle Shop. Let me show you Dolphin Tackle Shop. Ding dong. That's not worth 20 quid, is it? Real second hand rods. This is Kev Awards. Come to get some Mag Awards. Coats. Nice fishing boxes. Well, it's that time already. What are you giving me for Christmas, Kev? Look at fish. What are you giving for Christmas, Kev? The poles, all sorts of stuff, baits, some cheaper stuff here, worms, what reels, what? Sounds like the wriggling maggots off. Prices. They're not bad for them, are they? So that's Dolphin Tackle Shop. So we're going to order what we need and carry on. Take care, all. So we've got everything we need. We've got to send some new floats. joining us down up Canal today. Are you all right? Is that all right, love? Sorry. It's all right, people are running past and stuff. It's all right, don't. It's all right. So what I'm doing, I'm with Kev. Kev's just gone to the car in a minute. I'm fishing on one of these new dibbers that I've got. Fishing on that. That's number 8 elastic. £3 top main line, down to £2 bottom, size 20 up, and a smaller dibber. Another dibber, smaller float, but that's actually £5 line, down to £4 bottom, just in case they hook into any better fish, and running a 14 elastic. So I've been round and put underwater camera in straight in front of me, so I can see where the fish are, if there's any fish there or not. I know from last time, I come this part and I did first lots of underwater footage and I put it in. I seen that pike and some big perch and stuff. So I'm gonna see if I can pinpoint where we are. I'm gonna find out exactly where we are. If anybody knows this stretch, the white bridge is over there. We're not far from Anley, and I'm sat just after Rowy Trees. So there's a weir, and a young lad fishing further up. There's a weir just there. So we'll try this out and see if we can catch some fish. So stay tuned all, and like I said, Kevin's brought his new pole, bless him. He's getting used to using pole, so he's having a go up pole as well. So let's see if we can catch some fish. Take care all. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to fire some maggots across. I've literally just got here, got everything tackled up, put camera in, Kev set up, I'm set up. I'm going to fire a few maggots across on the far side. I am actually going to fish three swims. I'm going to fish 1, 2 and 3. So I'll ship it across. Tiny little dibber float on. I actually started and I put a little yellow one, I couldn't see it with my eyesight. I've changed over and everything's ready now. Waiting for Phil to come down to bring keep net, forgot to bring the other keep net. What I'm doing, just keep following the flow at the moment. I'm fishing a couple of inches off bottom. Quite cold this morning when we first got here. Waiting for temperature at water to get a bit hotter. It's not raining today, it's quite... So yeah, it's Sunday 20th. It's about 7 or 8 degrees at the moment. We've had quite a lot of rain in the last few days. So just for underwater footage, you know what date I'm here and what I'm doing. So what I'm going to do, start getting some baiting and stuff and try and work out what's going off, and start catching a few, we'll get back to you. Here's Kevin over there, he's catching a few fish, bless him. Laughing to assemble with his little milk carton pouch. So I'm going to make a couple of casts in here now. Starting to get a few bites on the far bank, really cold. Seem to have knocked fish off a bit. They've moved on to bait across far side, so I can get a few fish. I've had a couple up to now. Kevin's doing his usual trick, catching quite a few. I've lost about three good perch. Oh, I missed another lump out. On double white maggot a minute. Like I said, I've got stronger elastic and I've got 14s in. In case I hook a decent fish. Because on that side it's going that way, and on the inside it's going a bit left. Had a couple of trots here with worm. Get on the bite. Camera's been in for about an hour now. Nothing on that though. We're still down at the canal. Kevin's catching a few. I've had one little roach and lost about four or five decent perch. Water's down. It's really hard fishing. Don't know what's going off. So we said if we're not catching out next hour or so, we're going to pack up. Some days we have them days. So I'm waiting for Phil to come with his my keep net. He said he's going to bring me a keep net now. Just no fish. I'm going to take underwater footage. I'm going to get back. Kev's trying for the pike. He's got some nice perch. We do have them days. Temperatures dropped. See, I'm all wrapped up. Temperatures dropped from the other day. I'm only on single maggot. I've had a few bites, lost a few fish. Nothing at all. It's really hard fishing. So if we don't get any fishing next hour, I'll be weighing mine up with one little roach. And Kev will be beating me once again, won't you, Kevin? He's smiling again, look. He's over there smiling. See if we can get him on camera. Hang on, Kevin. Give us a wave, Paul. Yeah, I've had a guy come down and say he's the milkman. Aren't you, Kev? You're the milkman. there, so I say get it out of house anyway. It's not all about catching loads of fish. Water looks quite clear, if I'm honest, compared to what it's usually like. It just seems to be down in waters. It's dropped a couple of inch. Then fish just don't. Oh, got a bite. Go on. Go on then. Tiny little knock. Tiny, tiny little knock. Yeah, I don't know why fish the salt seems to be here. So I'll be watching underwater footage. Literally the other day when it underwater footage, it's 100 yards further up. Why come down to try and fish it? That was tiny, tiny little knock. Really cold. Nope, nothing. This is Kevin here, the milkman. we're going to pack up, it's starting to rain. Like I said, we're not getting bites or out. I've had that one little roach, I'll show you that. And Kev's had a few fish. So, that's what we're going to do. It's not been a very productive day. Like I said, some days you get that, but if you look on far bank, you can see that. See where the water's dropped. So water's dropped about, I'd say about a couple of inches, hasn't it, Kev?
Yeah.
It just don't seem to be the same. And I fished it a few weeks ago, just across the other side, obviously I did a video cut for YouTube. And I had a good chub and about 100 little fish. I had a really good day and I thought we'll come back to the same spot and try it. So I'm going to check underwater footage, obviously. You have days where the fish aren't there. So I'm going to wake these fish up, have a look at them, and then we'll get off. So we'll catch you on the next one. So I've lost some more miles in my rod race, and I was hoping to get some fish to put back in keep net. But it's one of them things. Got little wee mat here, look. A little mat, sorry. Make sure fish don't get damaged. He's not had loads, but got some nice fish again. You got them all, mate. He's done me again. Must be milk. Yeah. Nice perch, that, mate. That was a lovely perch. Did a little perch. Did a little bream, didn't ya? A little skimmer.
Yeah.
Well done, mate. 2, 4, 6, 7 fish, mate. So, hold your biggest one up, mate. Let's look at your biggest one. There you go. Brilliant. Super duper, mate, well done.
That's the big fish. Might have swam out that hole, little tiny little hole in a minute, mate. There we go. That's all I got. Oh, he's dropped him off floor.
Did a little roach.
Oh, dropped him off floor again.
Did a little roach. When he sits down. That's it. That's all I've had. So I've lost some miles here. Like Kev just said, do you want another hour so I can catch some more fish for the rod race? Literally, cars parked down there, so we're going to have an hour on this bit. So, hello, Mr. Milkman. Let's see if we can just get a few fish for the rod race. Cheers, Kev, for staying, mate. Thank you.
Alright, so I'm still waiting to record this bit, but I started getting a few fish. Got a few roach. Quite a few bites and some maggots. Probably a bite now. There's a lot of leaves coming down, Kevin.
Yes.
I'm going to go on this. We're all picking up a few fish at the Moose Swims. Thanking you, Kev, for giving me another hour to myself. Needed it, mate. There we go. That's the bottom part.
What do you know?
Is it?
Yeah. We might have got to change some other stuff. See? Yeah, I've got it full.
Kev's give me another 20 minutes. I've had 20 minutes fishing. It's getting really cold, you see. There's been a big rainbow. It's been chucking down with rain again. We're packing up, we've had enough. But I've had a few fish. Put them on grass. So you've just seen me catch that bream. So I've had another four fish.
Still not as many as what I caught.
No, mate, they've done well. Four more fish. I lost a few. 1, 2, 3. And that bream, 4. So that's it, we'll put these back in.
Can we see a face of an happy fisherman?
Yeah.
It's got me way for dance, that ass ball, hasn't it? Can she have a dance?
So, as you can see from the video, sadly, no species knocked off list. I'm just going to work out how many miles and stuff I've got left. Big shout out, firstly, to the two people that were doing the thing for the air ambulance. Absolutely brilliant. I'll try and put a link in the description below. Also, there's going to be a link in the description below for the free download of music I'm using. Thank you so much for that. Also, shout out to Darren from South Shields, all season sea fishing. And also, a shout out to David Lyons, tackling mines for people with mental health and stuff. So, absolutely brilliant what all these people are doing. So, take care all, and I'll just work out the miles and put that on end of video. And that's everything. So, stay tuned to the next one. The next one will actually be the underwater footage, what I'm just going through at the moment. I've not been very well for nearly a week. There's a bug or something going around
Luckily, I've not got COVID. I've tested for COVID. I've not got COVID. But I'm not feeling myself, so I'm really sorry that this is a bit late. But I didn't feel really good the day I went fishing, but you still get up and do it, don't you? So, one of the things. So, take care all, and we'll see you on the next one. So, take care. And so, there was 118 miles left in the keep net from the last road race. And it was 6 miles there, 6 miles back. So, including the 5 fish I caught, that'll leave 111 miles. Like I said, sadly, no more species off list. We're struggling at the moment. This week, we are supposed to be going to the River South, but there's been flood warnings in our area. So I don't know how that one's going to pan out. If we can get down there and do it, we will, because Kevin wants to do some stick boat fishing, and he wants me to teach him how to do some stick boat fishing. And he's getting used to pole now, so it's getting better. He's getting better and better at pole. He's doing really well, actually, if I'm honest. So well done, mate, for that. And we'll catch you on the next one. Take care.